Minister of Education, Mr. Abdullahi, Minister of Education, the State Minister, another Abdullahi, and the Vice Minister, Mr. Mukhtar, and the EU and Ambassador, His Excellency, Garrido Ruiz. I hope I pronounced very well. And also recognizing and Olivia, our head of public sector and social services for the EU. Also, I'm acknowledging the presence of the cabinet ministers from other ministries. I'm also acknowledging especially the education and implementing partners who are here with us today. And also appreciating all the invited guests and also everybody who has actually come to attend this occasion. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh and good afternoon. I take this opportunity once again to thank the Minister of Education, their leadership, for organizing this event today. And personally, I'm really proud how it has been done so far, and it really shows us the leadership that we're getting from the new administration. And for me, if I reflect back when we started this program in 2012, I remember this was we had a new approach called sector-wide approach. It was the first time actually we are trying to roll out that. And at the beginning, we were a bit kind of worried at how it's going to work and all that. And I remember, we used to have a lot of fragmentation in the education sector, where we used to have a number of partners doing different things. We used to have partners only doing teacher training. We used to have other people doing TVETs, some were doing specializing in secondary education, some specializing in primary education. But with the sector-wide approach, I think we're able to bring all that together and actually ask the partners, please work together. That's where the idea of consortium and came about. And just to let you know, in 2012 it was very difficult. We actually made us fight among ourselves for the little resources, but later we had to compromise and look at who has the value addition, who will bring expertise on the table. I think that's at the end of the day we were able to come up with a very competitive proposal, and that's why we were able to start the program in good time. And over the years, I remember very well, the first one was very successful, and that was actually evidenced by the final evaluation that we did. And we had an A rating. So you can, we do understand that's the best somebody can ever get in a evaluation, and I think that helped us to go to the second phase. And again, luckily, we equally good. We also got another A rating, which actually resulted in this third phase. So I think, and I can see a lot has already been said by the Director General on the achievements, so I do not want to repeat, but I can assure we had a lot of achievements for the last two phases. In particular, I want to say that we are really very proud, and especially on our growth enrollment for the school-going children. As you know, it's currently at 58.2%, and it came all the way from 29%. So for us, that's a very big achievement. But still, this means we have over 41% who are still out of school. And that actually requires all our support, especially our donors and as well as the government, to help us ensure we can have these children who are out of school, the 41%, back in school. I think that's one thing I really wanted to stress today, and I'm sure education is expensive, and so I think it's